Hello, and welcome to Jumpin' Johnny Gaming. This Legend of Zelda Tears of the Kingdom video shows you how to complete the shrine quest called North Necluda Sky Crystal. You first need to unblock the door of the Sahasra Slope Skyview Tower by going through the Sahasra Slope Cave on the right-hand side. You will need a weapon to break rocks, bombs, or Unibo Sage. It doesn't matter which side you go, it loops around to the same spot with a chest guarded by a few enemies. And an offshoot on the right hand side will be a rock you move with Ultra Hand, and you can get a bubble gem, and then go back just before the rock, and you can use the Ascend ability to get up to the tower and move the weapons, and the door will open and you can use the tower for the next stage of the quest. Once you are in the air, head to the islands on the right hand side and aim for the shrine on the right to activate the quest. And before you take the crystal over to activate the shrine, you can go around the island starting from the right hand side when facing the shrine and pick up some chests, a sage's will and an old map for a treasure location in the depths. There is a zonite dispenser and a treasure chest, and use the moving platform to launch yourself to the island above, and you can reach an island with a rock formation that has the sage's will. Return to the previous island and drop down the hull in the center of the island, and there is a treasure chest hanging up. And then join up 3 pieces of wood to make a bridge. Make sure the biggest piece is in the middle of the 3, and place it so the trest will drop down on the bridge, and hit the rope with an arrow to do so, and then return to the first island with the shrine. Use ascend to get to the previous island so you can paraglide there. Follow the green laser, and before you jump to the island that has the crystal, you will see a little curved floating platform, and if you move this with Ultra Hand, it will move the big curving floating platform. You want to connect the floating platform with the island with the crystal to the island to the left, and you can take the crystal and then go all the way around to the shrine. Several times you will need to stop and use Ultra Hand to place it, and be careful that the crystal does not roll down anywhere. Once you have placed the crystal, you can enter the shrine and collect your rewards. One last optional treasure before we finish is another old map location. Go back to the little curved floating platform, and there is a chest underneath the big curved floating platform. Move the little platform so the chest will land on the floating island underneath it, and then shoot it down with an arrow. If you like this video, subscribe to my channel, where there are more action-adventure gaming videos. Also, the channel has achievement and trophy guides, walkthroughs and secrets, and tips from the latest releases to classic retro games. Thanks for watching.